the day now. We're learning more about a man with no hands who threw a volleyball-sized boulder through a fast food window. Action 7 News reporter Liz McKernan has those details.
This is the man police say shattered two windows at a fast food restaurant. No small task for someone who doesn't have any hands. But a former neighbor says this man isn't who he claims to be.
I was shocked. Everything here is about, have you been to jail, things like that, to check on you, and suddenly I have my name on the web.
The neighbor says this isn't Kofi Umbairamaji, but instead is a man known as Ajabo from Burundi, a country in Central Africa. The neighbor says he knows because he is the real Kofi.
I couldn't even read, so how come someone who doesn't know how to read can get into my personal information?
The neighbor says the man came to Albuquerque 2 years ago as a political refugee. He doesn't know how Ajabo lost his hands, but says it's likely he had them cut off during a battle in his native country. Kofi says his handless neighbor can't speak or read English, only Swahili, and is getting help from a nonprofit charity.
I told them that the guy can't help himself. He couldn't cook. He couldn't communicate with people. Why don't they put him with his relatives down there? So they can help him. Why do they isolate him alone?
More questions in an already very puzzling case. In Albuquerque, Liz McKernan, KOAT, Action 7 News.
We are told Ajabo has relatives who live in town. He's still in jail on a $1,000 cash-only bond.